everything that causes sin. So we're not talking about guilt here. We're not. See, there's two aspects of sin. You have to keep them clear in your mind. One is the power of sin over us, and the other is the guilt of sin. They're not the same. People use them as the same. Oh, I'll be free from sin, meaning free from guilt. Christ has set me free from sin, but in their heart they mean free from guilt. But you have to consider there's a cause, and like I said, everything that causes sin, right? Not guilt, the causative factor, the thing that makes us sin, and all who do evil, all who do evil. They've been in the kingdom. They're taken out of the kingdom when? The end of the age. We don't know where. But as I say, it doesn't matter where. Because Christ is everywhere, isn't he? He's here right now. Because we're assembled in his name. He's also at the right hand of the Father. He's also in China. So, where is not the issue. The issue is sin. That's the issue. Harmatia. Right, Tony? Harmatia. Sin. Okay. They will throw them into the fiery furnace. Oh, joy. Where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. So evidently it doesn't burn them up, because if you were thrown into a fiery furnace today, you could not weep and gnash your teeth. I mean, you would be, you know, boom. But so this is some fiery furnaces. Some, I remember there was a fellow on drugs, and the Lord got tired of him doing it, and the fellow had a vision. And every time I think of it, I realize how terrible it was. He wasn't in any fire. He was in a box. He was just confined in a box. Can you imagine living in a box? And he said to the Lord, "How long am I going to be here?" And the Lord said, "Forever." And he let out a scream. And he got up, he flushed all his drugs down the toilet. That was in Dennis McNally's church that that happened. Yes. And the man after that testified about that many times, and then he passed away. His son was still in the church when I was there. But I thought of that many times, what it would be like to be in a box. Whoa. The Lord got him over his drugs that way. He tried to get the victory another time, to keep backsliding, backsliding. Finally, the Lord did a number on him. So, fiery furnace may be, you know, symbolic, because if you can still weep and gnash your teeth, you haven't gone into a furnace that burned you up. You're still able to function like the rich man in hell, his tongue burned. Put a little water on my tongue, or something to that effect. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Now remember, this doesn't have to do with accepting Christ. This is, means their behavior is righteous. Those with evil behavior are removed from the kingdom. Okay? So it becomes necessary for us. Now this will all be written out. The Lord uses us here for me to get my brain straight. Then I get up on Monday and I write this out on the pastor's page. So if you can't track with me tonight, I'll try to make it so clear. Not that I'm all that smart. The Lord tells me. Hope you realize that I don't think I'm smart. All right, now we're going to turn to Hebrews 10:14. Now, Here's a verse on which modern evangelical theology is based. Okay? I wouldn't bother you with these things, except they had a misunderstanding of them, have destroyed the church, which has destroyed our government, which is leading us straight into destruction. So it's not some idle theory. It's of the essence. Like $10 perfume. Okay. All right. It's verse 14. It's verse 14. Now, do you see how a person could read that and say, once I've accepted Christ, I'm free from the guilt of sin forever. Can you see that? I guess not. Can anybody see it? Maybe I better read it. Some are peering at it like it's Egyptian hieroglyphics. It's English. By one sacrifice. Now, when did that happen? On the cross. He, who's he? Jesus has made perfect forever. Now, I think the King James says those who are sanctified. And right there is the confusion, because scholars interpret sanctified means accepted Christ. So, if you accept Christ, you are without guilt forever. Now, that is current theology, boys and girls. Can you see it? If you don't see it, you won't be able to follow me where I'm going. You accept Christ. Now, all right, you're with me so far. You accept Christ. All right, now one of two things is true. And of course, this who are being made holy kind of takes away some of my spiz here. The King James makes it more like the current teaching. Because no, who knows what it means to be sanctified, but being made holy, we can grasp that. All right, now one of two things is true. If by the one sacrifice we are made perfect forever, translated, the guilt question is over, the guilt question doesn't exist anymore, and that's true. That's true. The new covenant does not permit a Christian to sin knowledgeably. It has no provision for that. The bulls and goats, yes. It had a provision for the person every year. The assumption was made. There had been a lot of sins committed that year. And so we have the Day of Atonement once more. Okay? But, now listen, I mean, this is so far different from what is commonly taught. There is no permission. The word isn't permission. It does not countenance. It does not accept. It does not assume. The New Testament, the new covenant of the blood of Christ assumes that you will not sin again for the rest of your life. Now, I'm going to have to explain that, but I want you to know that that's true. That's what it means when it says, by one sacrifice has perfected forever. It means guilt is no longer an issue, because we are assuming that people are going to follow Jesus. And so they don't have to worry about guilt, because the blood takes care of the guilt. Now, you can go one of two ways with this, and I cannot see a third. You can go one of two ways with this. You can say, therefore, I ought to try to live a decent life, but it's not critical, because Christ has forgiven me forever, no matter what I do. I will try to be nice, but it's not critical. Okay? That is the projected idea that dominates in Christian thinking. That's why they say, well, out of gratitude to our Lord, we should try to do better. We should try to do better. But by one sacrifice, he has delivered me My judgment was finished on the cross. I am never again going to be guilty of sin, because by one sacrifice he has perfected forever those who are sanctified. This says being made holy, which kind of causes us to stop and say, now wait a minute, that's conditional.